This question comes from Connor, who's asked, when building a high performance motorcycle engine, what are the key factors and what are the best components to change? Connor, that is a very, very large open-ended question. What are you trying to achieve? What sort of gains do you want? And what are you going to be using the engine for? Irrespective of whether it's an automotive engine or a motorcycle engine, what we need to consider, the factors in terms of making power, are always the same. If we're not using forced induction, really it's all about improving the volumetric efficiency of our engine, getting more air into the engine, getting more air out of the engine. The other thing we can consider is that we use RPM as a multiplying factor in our equation to make power. So if we look at the equation there, power is simply our torque multiplied by our engine RPM divided by a constant, which is 5,252. So if we want to make a lot more power, what we really want to do is focus on improving the airflow into the engine, or in other words the volumetric efficiency of the engine, at a higher RPM. That's why it's quite common to see race engines where the RPM limit is significantly extended. So yeah, those are a few aspects there. I would consider adding compression ratio if you're running on a good quality fuel. That will allow you to extract more power from the engine. This does depend again on the quality of the fuel though. If you run too much compression ratio on low quality pump gas, you're going to end up running into problems with detonation. The other aspect that will do a great job of improving the volumetric efficiency is having the head professionally ported. As long as that's being done by someone who actually knows what they're doing and has experience with your particular engine with some proven results, that can be a great result, a great way of improving the performance of the engine. Beyond that, it's other aspects that are actually outside of the engine, such as improving the intake system and the exhaust. So really, when we look at the performance engine build, we're not necessarily building a performance engine solely with the idea of improving power. The cylinder head and camshaft design, as I mentioned, that can be an element there, but really the bottom end in particular is more there to support the power reliably. So I can't be a little bit more specific, but that is a really big question. I'd need a lot more specifics to answer that accurately. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.